my dear students. Today, in this session, we are going to start with our English literature third unit, that is Fear and Courage. So, before starting with the lesson, let me introduce to the topic. In your textbook, there are two images in which there are two thoughts regarding courage. So first, let us see that. In first picture or in first image, you can see that courage is not the absence of fear, but the judgment that something else is more important than fear. The brave may not live forever, but the cautious do not live at all. That's what is written in the first image. And in second image, you can see that courage is the resistance to fear, mastery of fear, not absence of fear. Now, after reading this, what do you understand? What is courage? Courage means to overcome in all the odds. In life, we face so many difficulties which we have never expected. So, to overcome with these difficulties, that is called as courage. It's once we learn how to cope up with these difficulties, then we can do anything in life. In your book, there are many synonyms which are given for courage. So let us see which are those synonyms. Mettle, resolution, fortitude, spirit, guts, strength of mind, and they have also asked you to give more. So you can say bravery, valor, isn't it? So these are all synonyms of courage. So now let us start with the first lesson of third unit, that is The Hero, which is written by R.K. Narayan. So let us talk about R.K. Narayan. R.K. Narayan's full name is Rasipuram Krishnaswami Iyer Narayan Swami. He was born on 10th October 1906 in Madras. He is a legendary personality in Indian literature. He started his writing career in 1935 by writing the story Swami and His Friends. This story is very famous on TV series called Malgudi Days. He has also written many other stories such as The English Teacher, The Guide. You must have seen the movie The Guide. The main character of that movie was Devanand, isn't it? So that story is also written by R.K. Narayan. He has also written Waiting for the Mahatma, then The Man-Eater of Malgudi. So these are some works which are written by R.K. Narayan. Let us see the warm-up activity. There are certain pictures given in your book. So see the first picture. What do you see in this picture? There is a boy on the bed and there is someone under his bed. So, by seeing this picture, what do you feel? What must the boy be thinking? The boy is afraid. He thinks that there is a monster behind his So underneath his bed. Let us see the second image, wherein you can see the boy and behind him there is someone, isn't it? So in this picture, the boy is afraid or scared because he thinks that someone is following him. See, if it is a night time and you are walking alone, and if someone starts following you, how do you feel? You get scared, isn't it? Same way, this boy is also scared that he feels that somebody is following him. See the next picture. In this picture, you can see the boy has climbed the tree and there is a dog. So what do you feel? Why he has climbed the tree? Yes, to save himself from the dog. What do you do if the dog follows you? You try to run away, isn't it? You are also scared of dogs, right? So here the boy is trying to save himself from the dog by climbing the tree. Now let's see the next image. Now you can see the boy fallen down and there is a snake beside him. So what do you feel? How can you describe this picture? The snake has scared the boy and he fell down. So this was about the warm-up activity which is given in your textbook. Now let us talk about the characters of the story, the hero. So the first character is Swaminathan, or you can call him Swami. He is the main character of this story. The story revolves around him. He is a small boy who is studying in class 2. He loves to spend his time with his friends. And he is also scared or afraid to sleep alone. He always sleeps with his granny. Now let us see the second character, that is Swaminathan's father. So you all know that fathers are little bit strict than mother. So Swaminathan's father is also like other fathers. He is little bit strict with Swaminathan because he wants him to be courageous. He wants him to mold him in a good human being, and so sometimes he has to be strict with Swami. The third character is Swami's mother. As you know, mother loves her children very much. So similarly, Swami's mother also loves him a lot. Whenever his father tries to scold him, his mother pampers him a lot. Okay, next character is his grandmother, who lives along with them in their house. Most of the time, Swami sleeps with his grandmother. Whenever Swami sleeps with his grandmother, she tells him many stories. So this was about the characters in the story. So what do you think? What is the theme of the story? So in this story, you will find fear, you will find powerlessness, you will find independence, you will find
insecurity.
So these are the things which you can find in this story. So that is the theme of the story. So today I am going to just tell you in short the summary of this story. As I told you, this is a story of Swami. The story starts with the conversation between father and Swami. Father reads the news in the newspaper regarding a boy who saved himself from the tiger, and he asks Swami's opinion regarding it. But Swami feels that he may not be a boy. He must be some elder person or a strong man, because he feels that a small child is very afraid of animals, and so he doesn't believe that he may be a small child. So at that time, father tells Swami that strength is not important, courage is more important, and he asks Swami to prove himself courageous and assigns him a task to sleep alone in his office room. So in our next video, we will see what happens when Swami tries to sleep in his office room, in his father's office room alone. That's it for today. After listening to this video, you have to read the lesson twice and note down the meanings of difficult words in your English notebook. That's all. Thank you. Have a good day.